Hello friends, I'm Ankit Patwari. So today we will discuss dual aspect concept. Now dual aspect concept, jaise ek sikke, you have seen a coin, sikka, right? Uske jaise do pahelu hote head and tail, waise hi business mein jo bhi transactions hote hain, uske do aspects hote hain, ek receiving and another giving aspect. So basically we receive something and in respect of that we give something. So every business activity has two fold aspects, one receiving aspect, another giving aspect. So dual aspect concept bolta hai, for every debit there is a corresponding credit, and from here the concept of double entry system of accounting has developed. So what do you mean by for every debit there has to be a corresponding credit? I mean to say whenever there is a resource, right, for that we need to have a definite source. Say for example, started business with cash. So cash is a resource for the business, and who is the source of this cash? The owner. And anything contributed by the owner is known as capital in accounting language. So what does dual aspect concept says? That for every transaction has two aspects, one receiving, another giving aspect. So we can say that for every debit there is a corresponding credit, and from here the concept of double entry system has developed. So what do you mean by that? I mean for every resource there has to be a source. So dual aspect concept says there is an accounting equation that asset is equals to capital plus liabilities. Asset is equals to capital plus liabilities. Is that fine? Asset is equals to capital plus liability. Now this is a resource and these are the sources. Is that fine? So accounting in equation is what? Asset is equals to capital plus liability. Whatever be the activity of the business, whatever be the transaction, this equation will hold good. So I have taken a number of examples, right? What I will do, I will try to develop the accounting equation from this particular transactions. Is that fine? So let us first see the first example. The first transaction is cash invested into business rupees 20,000. So what is the resource business is getting? Receiving aspect is cash, and the giver of this cash is owner, that is capital. So our equation will be cash rupees 20,000, this is the resource, and capital rupees 20,000. Is that fine? For every debit there has to be a corresponding credit, for every resource there has to be a source. So we have developed the first equation. Now whenever we see the next transaction, so we will add on this particular equation, right? We are not going to develop a new equation for that. Purchase furniture for cash rupees 5,000. Now here what is happening? In all cases it is not necessary that for every transaction there has to be a resource and a source. It can also happen like that, ki you have one resource and with that resource you are purchasing another resource. So what I have done, I have used cash to purchase furniture. So what will happen? My cash resource will be now 15,000 plus I will have furniture rupees 5,000. So you can see that there is increase in one resource and decrease in another resource. So as a result this equation is still good. Yes or no? Next, purchase goods on credit rupees 10,000. Purchase goods on credit rupees 10,000. Now you can see that goods is a resource, you are getting goods, that is stock. And who is the provider of that stock? The person from whom you have purchased it on credit, and from whom we purchase goods on credit is known as creditors. So good is a resource and the provider of such good is creditor. So what I will do? I already had cash 15,000 plus furniture 5000 plus stock 10,000. So the total resource is 30,000. So we have capital 20,000 plus creditors 10,000. Is that fine? Right? So as of now, we have seen dual aspect concept says for every resource, there is a source. For every resource, there has to be decrease in another resource, right? Sold goods for cash rupees 12,000, right? So what is happening? You are giving one resource, you are getting another resource. You are giving one asset, you are getting another asset. So goods, there is a decrease, and cash, there is an increase. So what is happening? Cash was already 15. Now it has increased by 12,000. So the new cash balance will be 27,000 plus furniture is same 5,000 plus stock will decrease by 7,000, right? Stock will decrease by 7,000. So the new stock balance will be 3,000. So there is an increase in one asset by 12,000 and decrease in another asset by 7,000. This indicates growth in your net worth. And this growth in your resources is known as net profit. And who is eligible for this net profit? The person who has provided the money. The person who is doing all the activities. Right? In Hindi we say khoon pasina, right? Sab kuch owner ka hai, toh ye profit bhi owner ko milega. So in that case, your capital will increase by 5,000, that is new capital balance will be 25, plus your creditors will remain the same. So now you can see 27 plus 5 plus 3, 35, and here also it's 35. Last but not the least, provide depreciation on furniture rupees 1,000. Now depreciation means I have derived the benefit. And this depreciation will be regarded as expense. So what is happening? My cash balance remains the same. Furniture resource, the value of furniture will decrease by 1,000. So the new balance is 4. Plus there is no change in stock. Is equals to. Now depreciation means it's an expense. Now when profit, owner is eligible for profits, so for any expenses and loss, owner has to bear that. So this 1,000 depreciation will be borne by the owner. So what will happen? I will decrease the capital balance, so the new capital balance will be 24 plus creditor is still the same. So this is basically dual aspect concept. For every resource, there has to be a source. For every debit, there is a corresponding credit. As simple as that. So from dual aspect concept, this accounting equation has been developed and it forms the basis for double entry system of accounting. And on the basis of this, golden rule, right, traditional method of doing accounting, the modern approach of doing accounting has been developed. That is why we say in case of personal account, in case of golden rule, and there is a classification personal, real, nominal. So in case of personal, debit the receiver, debit what comes in means the receiving aspect. Credit the giver, credit what goes out, that's the giving aspect. Right? So debit that, credit that. So it has been developed from this dual aspect concept. So the dual aspect concept means for every resource, there has to be a source. And that has been taken to develop double entry system. Every debit, there has to be a corresponding credit. So you have seen from this equation, increase in asset, increase in liability. Increase in asset, decrease in another asset. Again, increase in asset, increase in external liability. Then next we seen, increase in one asset, decrease in another asset. So the net worth is your profit. So that increase in capital. decrease in asset, decrease in capital, the depreciation part. Say for example, I take number 6, payment to creditor rupees 4000. Now tell me orally what will happen. So this cash of 27,000 will become 23. Rest items will be same. And your creditor from 10, it will become 6,000. So like it will go on. You give me any number of transactions, I'll put up in this and this equation will always hold good. Is that fine, everyone? So this is dual aspect concept from our side. So next class, we will be back with some more interesting concepts. Namaste.